I am doing my master's thesis down at Woods Hole. I am looking at olfaction thresholds in smooth dogfish. Olfactory thresholds basically imply how well a shark smells. So everybody's heard the myth of a shark can smell a drop of blood within an Olympic-sized swimming pool, and I'm actually trying to see if that is true or not.
The task for Ashley is to determine what odor concentration is trackable for the shark.
The odor that I'm using is made from squid. It is a combination of squid and seawater. Squid smoothie, if you will. I set it up by creating two odor plumes.
If you want to see it, we put in a dye. And by the time we know it has reached the animal, we lift the gate and then we see it track the odor plume straight to the source. One critical thing that was necessary for these experiments to succeed, that Ashley is doing for her master's, is to get the animals motivated to do this. Because it turns out, sharks are much smarter than anyone ever thought. They swim up the plume, they go to the source, they bite the source, and there is no food. They will do it a second time, but after that they say, forget it. So Ashley learned how to feed the sharks from a stick, and she taught the sharks to not be afraid of the stick. And once they were not afraid and knew that when they run the odor plume and they get to the source, that comes the stick with the food.
I don't believe, just from my preliminary look at my data, that their olfactory threshold is as high as we think that they are. So by that I mean they can not detect very minute amount of odor. I think that my observations of them tracking very dilute odors is more based on them learning where they get food rewards rather than the actual odor driving them to track something. And I think this is applicable from an outside perspective. Sharks go to where they know they can eat. In Cape Cod, for example, they go to Martha's Vineyard because that's where the harbor seals are.
So this seems to be something that is important to sharks. They can learn.